want to talk about social media in a very interesting context here. This is the GAA. Now, the Gaelic Athletic Authority has told clubs to stop using WhatsApp altogether. I have to say, I use WhatsApp for everything. We have a WhatsApp group for this radio program. The boys, when we go to see rugby, we've got a WhatsApp group all year round. I'm in WhatsApps for all sorts of reasons. Most of my mates, it's cheaper as well, because you use WhatsApp, you're not charged text messages. You can put photographs in it, whereas if you send a photograph on an email off your phone, it's 48 pence, or it is on my phone. I might be entitled. But WhatsApp is free for everything, and internationally so. Anyway, this is the GAA primarily say, this is because of GDPR concerns, General Data Protection Regulation, in terms of those who are in a group and the exposure that they have to everybody else in that group. Maybe there's 100 in your WhatsApp group. Well, not just that, but what happens if somebody puts up something that you're deeply offended by, something pornographic, something racist or whatever, and then there's an issue if that person who put it up leaves because you can't take their stuff down, not even if you're an administrator. Well, with his thoughts on all of that is the Professor of Cybersecurity at the Ulster University. That's Professor Kevin Curran. Kevin, good to see you and good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Mark.
We've got a hair on that microphone, listen. We have. Kevin, would you care potentially, thank you, just to go to the white microphone to your right. Thank you very much indeed. Sorry about that, chaps. Kevin, it's a fabulous app. It needs to be said first. Zuckerberg bought it. It's in the Facebook stable and it's popular because it's so darn good. Let's be blunt.
It is popular, yeah. They used to charge a pound for it years ago. Then they removed that and there's always a risk of ads coming in. But it's de facto a messaging app in most of the world, really, as you rightly say. There's no charge for using it. Group, every family seems to have a family group now. And it's very popular and it's got end-to-end encryption. So WhatsApp themselves cannot see your messages.
Do you believe that?
I believe that because, yes, of course, yeah. But there's nothing to stop them mining what we call metadata, maybe to see who's contacting who. But I do believe, yeah. No, end-to-end encryption works. You can't defeat them at
all. You believe there's a guy, a girl in a silo somewhere in Iceland or Bangladesh who's got all the access codes there and can't see who you're WhatsApping?
There has been a few vulnerabilities. In fact, last year, just recently, there was 12 vulnerabilities in WhatsApp, which was a way up from the year previously, which was only two. But generally, these are nation-state actors, and we know that the NGO group, the Israeli hacking group, was one of them who developed this exploit. But these cost millions of dollars. So unless you're the most high-profile person, you know, in a country or whatever, like Jeff Bezos, for instance, you're not going to be. An ordinary person will not be exploited using these vulnerabilities. It really is safe. But there is safer apps, I will say, that people in security who contact me, people who are more privacy conscious, will use something like Signal or Telegram.
Well, there you go. Well, let's go to the heart of the GAA here then, Kevin, because the point here is that a member in a WhatsApp group was putting up something unsuitable or seeing your number. Say you had a kid playing Gaelic and the parents' number is up on that. That's seen by everybody. There are data protection issues there. The Laois County Board have urged clubs not to use WhatsApp. They say this week, Laois GAA, their children's officer, Seamus Lahart, declared, "I can't stress it enough, you have to scrap WhatsApp."
I don't agree with them. I think they've misinterpreted the spirit of GDPR. You know, general data protection regulations are excellent. They're brought in April 2018. They protect the consumer from abuse of our data by companies. In other words, companies now have to be more responsible about how they use our data. They can't use the dark art of subscribing us to newsletters without us actually taking it anymore. They have to protect the data. They can't send it on to third parties. In other words, it does exactly what you would want with regards to legislation. Now, the GAA say that every time there's a group for any kind of club that the parents' profile and details will be seen by all, and they didn't give their consent, but they did. They joined the group. They have given their consent. And also then about, yes, there is an issue that generally with GDPR, you're able to ask a company to remove data, you know, about you. But with WhatsApp, a group, you cannot go back and delete the message. But still, this is just an outlier. It's an anomaly. Again, the person who might have put something on there that was wrong, you know, use legal cases against them or whatever else, and also the data being transferred outside the EE. I don't agree with that. I think they really are being silly about this.
Croke Park have stepped in as well, Kevin. They've told RTE that they plan to release their own communications app.
I know.
The games management system that's currently in development. It'll be out by the summer.
I mean,
but then what's to stop that being abused in exactly the same
well,
manner?
It can, I mean, yeah, in that case, they can put some kind of more explicit consent in. They can also delete. They obviously are going to have a way for moderators to delete the information if there was something harmful posted or whatever else. Mm. But I'm cynical on that, actually, about that. And I do not agree with this. I think they misinterpret the law completely.
All right, then. So the bigger picture and the whole thing, I mean, I do think it's very interesting, Kevin, you know. You can be in a group and then somebody says something and you're going, oh, for goodness sake. And then, you're the worst in the world if you leave and all the rest, you know.
By the way, the easiest way to hack on WhatsApp is if you have access to someone's phone, you just have to connect it for a few minutes to your laptop. Download the desktop WhatsApp application, connect the other person's phone, and then you're connected until they disconnect you. It can be weeks later, months later. You're seeing all their messages.
And should a professor of cybersecurity be letting that be known?
It's well known in the hacking forums. Yeah.
Well, there you go.
Yeah.
So that by letting that be known, you're almost like laying down the issue to them. If I can do this, you need to fix it.
Well, you can see it two ways. First of all, now people should be able to go into settings and check to see what devices are being accessed in your WhatsApp. And if you don't recognize any, then disconnect from all devices and log in again.
I get it. And a caller makes the point, I think, if you want to join a group, oh, that's a great group. That's, you know, that's the Tiernan Oaks, the GA, our kids and that. Great. And the moderator then adds somebody that you don't know, Kevin. They then have access to your number. I've seen that in WhatsApp groups. So that, you know, BBC ones, maybe people join and you're going, I don't want them to have my phone number, but they've been added after you've joined.
You know, we've had telephone directories for a century. Yeah. If you don't
but nobody has them anymore.
Exactly. I'm just saying that if you don't want your number to be, then don't join the, you know, don't, if you don't want your number ever going out, don't join any group. Just accept that.
Simple.
Yeah.
All right, Kevin, no bother at all. Anything else on your radar when I have you? Just, it's always, you always have your, what about the Huawei thing?
Yeah.
You're a Huawei man, aren't you?
Yeah, I support that. I don't see any. I think this is economics. This is the United States cleverly fighting a giant in technology who's taken over the technology space and the consumer handset market as well.
Yeah. But if you were the CEO of Huawei in a totalitarian state, which is non-democratic, and the head of the country says, Kevin, I'd like you to take a look inside your algorithms for Mr. Trump's niece or Mr. Trump's activities, you do it.
The same as the United States, yeah. The United States have secret service letters where a company, they can, if you're contacted by them and they want information from you, you cannot reveal that you have been contacted. Your hands are completely tied. Again, so a lot of countries are doing this. You wouldn't believe how many of the Huawei employees, I mean, they're a huge organization, but a lot of them are from European countries and, you know, Americans are working for them as well. And
but they would be. I mean, it's a global player, but it's that issue of who owns...
Yeah.
Your intelligence, the thinking at the heart of your state.
Yeah.
You like to think that your politicians do. Is that a myth? Probably is.
Possibly. But again, we've never found a smoking gun as yet. You know, and the United States will come along and if they provide evidence that there is, but there hasn't been. The source code is being examined by the National Cybersecurity Center in Banbury. There's a camera pointing at a computer and there is access to the code and no one else can go in and authorize access to this computer. They've been doing it for 10 years. Mm. And they're audited more than Nokia and Ericsson. Again, if you're a country and you want to snoop, you just hack the routers, the switches. GCHQ were accused of this by the Belgian authorities just 2 years ago. A whole report was revealed that they were spying on European politicians by hacking the largest ISP in Belgium. Hmm. So countries are doing this all the time, you know, and it's always been there. But again, you just hack what's there. You don't have to own the equipment.
All right. Thank you indeed, Kevin. Professor Kevin Curran there from Ulster University. So food for thought on all that. Kevin said if you don't want to be exposed to other people in WhatsApp groups, well then don't use WhatsApp, which is eminently sensible, I suppose, when you think about it in that sense.